Namo Buddhaya Jai Bhi. Wishing you all peace and happiness on Buddha Purnima and always. I am Snehal Mandape. I would like to share some information on significance of Buddha Purnima as well as Buddha and Buddhism. Buddha Purnima, also known as Buddha Jayanti, is a day when Buddha was born on full moon day of Vaishakh, April to May. It is said that Buddha was born and attained Mahaparinirvana, leaving the mortal coils on the same day of Buddha Purnima, having lived on the earth for 80 years. Triply auspicious. Buddha also attained enlightenment, that is Nirvana, on the same day. That is why Buddha Purnima is considered triply auspicious. In Buddhism, enlightenment is a final spiritual state in which everything is understood and there is no more sufferings or desire. Gautam Buddha is considered as one of the greatest spiritual leaders the world has ever seen. Also known as the guiding light of Asia, his message for peace captured hearts and minds of millions of devotees around the world. Traditionally, this annual festival is observed by Buddhists as Vesak. Though it is known as the celebrations of Buddha's birthday, it encompasses all the stages of his life, including Buddha's birth, his enlightenments, that is Nirvana, and passing away from this mortal world, that is Mahaparinirvana. Buddha Purnima, from the start, has been a very important festival and highlights the significance of Gautam Buddha's teachings of love, life, peace and spirituality. Now we'll see Buddha and Buddhism. As a child, Siddhartha, the Buddha, was troubled by some of the same thoughts that the children of today's generations have. They wonder about birth and death. They wonder why we get sick and why our all the wishes do not come true. Children also wonder about happiness and beauty in nature. Because the Buddha knew what was in the hearts of children and humankind. He taught everyone how to live happy and peaceful life. Buddhism is not learning about strange beliefs from the faraway land, but it is about looking at and thinking about our own lives. It shows us how to understand ourselves and how to cope with the daily problems. Buddhism is one of the major religions in the world. It began around 2500 years ago in India when Siddhartha Gautama discovered how to bring happiness into the world. Buddha's nature was full of positive qualities. Whenever he went outside among others, he won the hearts of people because he dealt with their true feelings. He advised them not to accept his words on the blind faith, but to decide for themselves whether his teachings are right or wrong and then only follow them. He encouraged everyone to have compassion for each other and develop their own virtue. You should do your own work, for I can teach only the way. He never became angry or impatient or spoke harshly to anyone, not even to those who opposed him. He always taught in a such a way that everyone could understand. Each person thought the Buddha was speaking especially for him. The Buddha believed in a balanced life. He preached to follow middle path, which means neither living a life full of luxury nor giving up all the worldly possessions. He stressed on the actions which which can create happiness for oneself and others. He laid stress on ahimsa, that is non-violence. He did not approve of any rituals or any kind of sacrifices. He wanted all the people to be treated equally. He did not approve caste system. He was against the caste system. He believed that what we do in our life, that is karma, affects us. And that was the reason Dr. Baba Saheb Ambedkar chose Buddhism over all other religions in the world. Buddhism is the only religion where there are no caste system, varna system, untouchability and discrimination. It believes in liberty, equality, fraternity and Panchasheel, which no other religions do. As auspicious the festival of Buddha Purnima is, Lord Buddha quotes inspired humility and will help us to attain peace and dedicate our life for the good cause. I would like to conclude my speech with an inspirational thought by Buddha, with an inspirational quote by Buddha: what you think, you become. What you feel, you attract. What you imagine, you create. Thank you.